And we're back. Hold on. Got the last bullet out.
All right.
I'm pretty sure wherever it was, I probably should go to the hospital after this. I'm dying this week, everybody.
I'm mostly over my cold.
Yes, but well, tune in next time. Where Mark Miller will probably shoot Eric or something, or maybe he'll be protected by the iconic Red Ranger.
No, I can't get killed. I still have my lawsuit going on with Todd McFarlane. I can't
Yeah.
miss that.
What are you trying to like win from Todd McFarlane, Eric?
Oh, nothing. I just I'm getting sued over whether I'm allowed to own a Spawn comic or not.
Oh.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Because
Yes.
apparently I somehow now own part of the rights to Spawn, and so yeah. Anyways, so New York Comic Con was this week, and we got a bunch of news. And I guess we can run through all of it, but
Yeah.
there were two ones that really stuck out to me. The first one is the Godzilla comic book, which has one of the
Godzilla.
it has an awesome cover.
Is it the one with the eye?
Yes.
I know, right?
It's and on CBR, the link that we have here is iFanboy, but on CBR they had like a whole article talking about it, and like it's not just going to be like the old Godzilla comics where it's like Godzilla but like in the Marvel universe they have to make stuff up. This is Godzilla, but they're like making their it's essentially a new Godzilla continuity, and we're going to get King Ghidorah and Mothra and Rodan and all those characters are going to be here, but there's also going to be new stuff, and I'm really excited for this. I really want to pick this up when it comes out because I love Godzilla and this just sounds awesome.
It does, and I'm not a big Godzilla fan, but I want to read this. It sounds awesome.
But the other big thing is the announcement that Iron Man is it says here returning to its original numbering of issue 500. But I'm telling you, if I pick that comic book up and in the cover gallery the Iron Man Director of S.H.I.E.L.D. issues are counted, I'm calling shenanigans because that's a different book.
I call
Director of
shenanigans!
S.H.I.E.L.D. ran at the same time as Iron Man. That is a different book. Those do not count in the same numbering. Anyways, I am psyched out of my mind for this. Because if you look at the link I sent you, it has that big like poster, the Iron Man poster thing.
Oh, I love the guy who does these.
That
He
is
does
amazing.
epic posters
My
for
comic
everything.
book store had the Thor one. I really hope they get this one because I will buy it. It'll probably be about $25, but I will buy this poster because it is amazing. It has all these different like Iron Man armors and then a bunch of different like Iron Man villains. Like every Iron Man villain ever is there. Even there's this really, really silly Iron Man villain that's in the Ironmonger story. Who if did you have the picture up? Pull up the picture.
Yeah, I have it up.
Okay, all right. Go over to where the Bleeding Edge armor is.
Hold on, hold on. My computer is running slow. Okay, I'm there.
All right. You see the Bleeding Edge armor?
Yes.
And the Mandarin's above him.
Hold on, it's still running slow. Yes.
Okay, now below that is a guy with a purple outfit and a silly helmet.
Yes.
Yes, he's awesome. In the Ironmonger story, he steals Tony Stark's armor and puts the armor on over that costume. It's awesome.
Purple outfit with like wings on the
Yeah,
helmet?
yeah.
That's Dreadknight, isn't it?
No, it's not Dreadknight, somebody else.
It looks like Dreadknight from the animated show.
I'm almost positive it's not. I guess maybe that is Dreadknight. Maybe that's not the villain I'm thinking of, because there's a villain that dresses very similar. Maybe that is Dreadknight. Curses. That Dreadknight's cool.
I have dreaded you, Eric.
You're right. That is Dreadknight. God damn it. I don't know who the other villain is, but I thought it was him. I was like, that's really cool, because he was
The
from
guy
way
right
back.
below him? Are you sure you don't mean the guy right below Dreadknight? Who's like in this arm pose?
The Target guy? No.
Oh,
But
okay.
this is an amazing cover, and I love it. I want it so bad. Everything in this picture is really cool. But in the there was just this release that they're doing issue 500. But then they talked about like what it's going to be. Apparently, everything Fraction's been doing has been one big story, and that this issue is going to like reveal all the stuff that's been there the entire time that we haven't known.
That's going to be awesome because I got both World's Most Wanted from that
Yeah,
sale this week.
apparently there was stuff in all of those storylines that is setting up like the Mandarin that we don't even know about yet, but like it's there. I'm psyched out of my mind for this. I cannot wait.
Who cares the Mandarin?
Exactly.
Wow, I didn't think that would fit. Let's see. This is going to take a while because we got a lot to talk about here. I'm just going to read down from the Godzilla thing on that iFanboy one. It says apparently James Robinson is working on a Hawkman series. Exactly.
Good luck with all of that.
Yeah, they're trying to fix it in brightest day right now. It's been okay, but I'm just thinking, you're fixing Hawkman. That's like fixing a car that was crushed into a cube.
It's not possible. That you can't fix Hawkman. The best you can hope for is a complete and total reboot where you get to make the character from the ground up. And
then, we have to be the guy who fixes it.
And then the writer after you completely changes everything, and you're in the same
position. And it begins the cycle.
Yeah.
Let's see. You want to go the next one?
Yeah, the next one is that Brian Bendis and Alex Maleev are actually going to reunite, and apparently, if you don't know, they're famous for Daredevil. Their work on Daredevil has never sold more than when they were on it. Like, literally, it was a top 10 book when they were writing it. And even Brubaker on it with Michael Lark didn't sell like Bendis and Maleev did. And it's some really good work. Apparently, they are reuniting, and they're going to work on Moon Knight. And I really want to read that. Because
here's the thing. If Maleev's art's going to be the same way it looked in Spider-Woman, I don't know.
Well, you might have that, because I kind of have that with Brian Hitch, where, like, if somebody announced now that Brian Hitch was on something, I'd be excited, and I'd remember he's not as good now as he was.
Oh, did you ever read the New Avengers finale?
No, but I
saw... Duff looked.
I saw Captain America Reborn, and that was terrible artwork.
Well,
it's not terrible. It's a lot...
He didn't do all of it, either. People. He did, like, half of it.
I know, but it's certainly not... what he was doing with Ultimates 2, like, that was...
Oh, yeah, love his career. And I just got that gigantic JLA Heaven's Ladder. Good God, that's beautiful.
Did he draw that?
Yeah, he drew the whole thing, and it's humongous.
I've not read it, I just... All right.
It's probably going to be hard to find. It came out 10 years ago.
Well, aren't you special?
I am. I got two $35 books for $5. True, they're horribly damaged, but I got them for $5.
Way to go.
I know. Yeah, so they're going to be doing Moon Knight, and I didn't even know the other one was canceled. Vengeance of Moon Knight. I like that series.
Is it?
I just forgot. Yeah, they're doing this, so it's canceled.
Well, but that doesn't mean it's canceled. They could just cancel it. They could cancel it. It doesn't mean it's canceled now. I don't
even know if it's out now. I forgot about it for a while. Anyway, in February, Marvel brings us Onslaught Unleashed. Let's get the hell out of here.
Because when I think Marvel... And then what I think Marvel should do, I think Onslaught.
Yeah, that always...
I think Missed Opportunities, I think Onslaught.
I never read it, and I don't want to read it.
And then they're like, much beloved writer Steve McKeever. Have you ever heard of Sean McKeever. Have you ever heard of Sean McKeever?
I don't know. Let's ask Mark Millar.
I've never heard of Sean McKeever.
He's still polishing the gun. He did Teen Titans after Geoff Johns left. That's all I know.
Things about that run, so...
Yep. See, the next thing we already talked about, the renumbering. Nick Spencer's going to be writing a new War Machine series called Iron Man 2.0.
I hate that title.
I'm guessing, let's see, a War Machine ongoing. Hey, Greg Pak, how'd that go?
Yeah.
Not well. Okay.
Well, that was kind of doomed to begin with, but... Still,
he was Cyborg from the Teen Titans, but with more guns.
Yeah, but I don't know. I'm cool with. I'm not gonna read it because I'm not really a War Machine fan. But I feel like it's a grave disservice to the character to call it Iron Man 2.0. At the same time, you might get more people to pick up the comic calling it Iron Man 2.0.
They'll be tricked.
Yeah,
Tony Stark's not in here. I've been deceived. Let's see. The next thing I mentioned already, but...
Yeah, Nick Spencer, Jimmy Olsen co-feature is going to be a one-shot.
That guy's getting big now. But next thing is he's writing something called The Infinite Vacation for Image. I'm probably not going to read it.
Yeah, I won't either.
I don't read anything about
Image. Issue 60 of Supergirl will be taken over by Nick Spencer.
And it'll be done by Bernard Chang. And I've read some of that recently. It's good, like,
I've
as a
not read
guy.
Supergirl. I don't know. I've never had much interest in Supergirl outside of when Peter David wrote her. And even then, I've only read like two issues because for some reason DC won't collect that trade, so.
There was an awesome issue of Batgirl where Supergirl comes in and they fight an army of vampires that come out of that comes that, because there was this experiment happening like a building over from the college they're at, and they're watching like old scary movies, and the machine causes like 26 Draculas to come out because the film was 26 frames per second.
Oh,
It's amazing.
that's inconvenient.
I know, it's awesome. Okay, next this one here.
Victor Gishler's next arc in X-Men, after the widely popular and critically acclaimed X-Men versus Vampires, we get Serve and Protect,
That sounds like a crappy sci-fi movie,
which,
doesn't it?
what, yeah, which will find him teamed up with fan favorite Chris Bocciolo and find the
Who?
ex
I don't
Bocello?
know who that is.
Bocello.
I don't know who that is, I
Oh,
think.
he's I know who he is, but by name, I wouldn't necessarily recognize his artwork. And find the X-Men teamed up with Spider-Man against an
Really?
evil
That's so
foe of
new.
his. The story will be the first of many seeking to bring the outcast mutants back into the superhero fold of this in this heroic age. Yeah, because the
No.
X-Men weren't in Civil War or Secret Invasion or even World War Hulk. I mean, they're
No,
certainly
they.
really out there.
Yeah, we're closed off. Isn't that right, Steve Rogers? You're standing right next to me.
And there's that
That's right.
cool Spider-Man costume again. What is that?
I don't know. And apparently they're doing because Dan Slott's gonna bring it in, and amazing. I have no idea. It looks cool,
It does.
and it's bright red this time.
Yeah, I'm just now remembering that we covered a story a while back that an
And it
alternate
was
cover.
green.
Yeah.
You and me are simple. Okay, let me check the time. Okay, we still got 3 minutes. There will be a Jubilee, a Wolverine and Jubilee 4-issue mini.
This.
They describe it as X-Men's Batman and Robin.
There's a problem with this. It's
What is it?
20 years late.
Exactly.
If they were to do a Wolverine and series now, it should be Wolverine and Pixie, because Pixie is the because we had Kitty Pryde and then Jubilee was kind of the new Kitty Pryde, and Pixie is kind of now that character, so it should be Wolverine and Pixie.
Wasn't Armor kind of like that and
Armor
Astonishing?
wasn't astonishing, but so actually it could probably be a toss up. You could probably do Armor instead of Pixie. It doesn't really matter, but it shouldn't be Jubilee. That time has passed, about 20 years ago.
Yep.
Who's writing it?
Catherine Immonen and Phil Noto's doing the art.
Eminem. That name sounds familiar.
Well, the artist Stuart Immonen, but Catherine Immonen, you know what's weird? She did a Pixie
Oh,
miniseries.
did she?
Yeah, Pixie Strikes Back.
Oh, well, doesn't
She
that just
also
sound
did like
crazy?
a Hellcat mini. She's been doing like these minis with random female Marvel characters lately.
So, as of issue 36, Warren Ellis will be leaving Astonishing X-Men.
And replaced by the perfect person, Daniel
It'll
Way.
be replaced by Daniel Way. Now, this means that Daniel Way is now going to inherit the book that never ships ever. So you can look forward to seeing issue 37 somewhere around 2013, maybe 2014.
One moment, real quick. Keep talking. Fill in my
All
dialogue.
right. So I will be turning over all rights and profits of the Comic News Show to Eric because I'm just that cool of a guy. All right. Speaking of astonishing things, we're getting into
Eric,
some.
can you, Eric, did you say anything bad while I was gone?
No.
What's this contract for?
It's just your power to attorney. It's nothing.
The
We're
best part about
I was
this.
about to announce that we're getting an astonishing Captain America.
That's my part, though. Yes, Astonishing Captain America, written by Andy Diggle, who is British, and I have nothing against that. I just want to point that out. And the art's going to be done by, how do you say his name? Adi Granoff.
Yeah, I think it is. All
Can he
right.
do? Will this come out on time? I like. Has he been delayed? Because he doesn't do art that much. Like.
I don't I think Extremis came out on time or Extremis came out on time. That's the only thing I know he's ever done.